Okay, hi everybody. So I just wanted to share some things from our homeschooling. So this is my homeschool planner that I use. It has the term outline, weekly routine, timetable, monthly planner. So the monthly planner is a calendar like that where I can write in every day what we're doing. And then the next section is our year. So our year is... Keep going. Our year is, this is the calendar, so I've marked out our dates and our times and our holidays. And then we've got our year at a glance. So everything that we do for the year is already organized and ready. So for example, in August, we will be having the Science Alive convention that we're going to in Adelaide, as it's Science Week and then also Book Week. Shayla, my eldest, is a left-hander. So August 13th, we'll be celebrating Left Handers Day. Then we have things like in May, we've got Reconciliation Week and learning about the 67 referendum and the Eddie Mabo vote, because we're Aboriginal. We are... Good job. And we are... We'll be learning about that. And then in July, we have NAIDOC Week. So there's a whole bunch of things that we... will be studying this year, as these are the main important days, but that's other things as well. So then we've got goals, which we haven't even filled out yet. So then I have things like rewards and awards. Then we've got, that's our homeschool curriculum. So I write down everything what we're doing. And then the next one is, there are subjects. So then I'll have Christianity, English, maths, science, geography, certain posters that we stick around, like, so we've done that. And then that's the answer keys that I have. Okay, so then it must, I don't know why you've got to. Okay, so today we have done our creation science book. So today we usually work at the kitchen table, but today we're doing a mummy's bedroom day. So Shayla is, say hi Shayla. Shayla's 8 and she's in grade 3, and she is, right now we're doing dinosaurs, and shows she's matching up the cards, the paleontology cards, that I got off of, hang on a minute, it's all the thing, researchparent.com. These are amazing. So these are the dinosaur cards and the paleontology cards that I cut up, and they match. So RJ is doing, RJ 7, he's in grade 2, and he's doing the dinosaur ones. Oh, yeah. So we have, hang on, so we have the Triceratops. Gives you a bit of information about what it is, what its name means, how big it is, and what period it's from. So then they're doing those. So that's what we're doing. And then next we'll be doing our time. So we have these time things, and Tan and RJ both learning about time. And then the next thing will be our Australian story. Now this is my favourite, our Australian story. So it gives us, hang on a second, it gives us all this information, and then we've got pictures to go with it, and then the kids have language lessons to go with it. So it's got these, Unit 1, Lesson 1, Read Aloud. We do the Read Aloud, which is the Great Southern Land, our Australian story. That's from, what's her name? Janet. I'll find that out. I'll get the information and put it in the comments below. We'll put the link in. So then we have, that's Janet's Pictures of Australian History. So then they do the activities. So we've got dictionary work. So it's the language lessons to go with the history. Then we've got narration. So it's Christian based. So we have talking about in the beginning, Genesis in chapter 1, about God creating it. And then as we go a bit further along, we are Aboriginal, so we love the fact that it starts teaching about flora, fauna, and then Australia's first. So it has all information on the Aboriginal history. Hang on, I'll help you in a second. So then we have dictionary work, map work, so it ties in history, English, and geography. as well as Christianity all in one. And so we also do... All right, so Shayla's done her cards.
And I want to say what
excellent.
This is.
She wants it, to show...
I think it's something. Called Coprolite.
Yeah.
It says here... Was it fossilized feces?
Fossilized feces. What are feces?
No idea.
Poo.
Oh, yeah!
I should have said that because that was...
Okay, go.
The solid waste passed out of the body, commonly known as poop, can provide information regarding an animal's diet.
Yeah. So it tells you what they ate. All right, RJ, are you done? Almost.
I don't have enough room to put all my things.
Oh, you don't have enough room on this desk. Okay, so then you can just put them over here. You can just pile them on top of each other. That's okay. Fine. Because then at least I know you've done them. And then I want you to pick one dinosaur. And then once they've picked their dinosaur. Where's the dinosaur sheet? Here.
Hi, people.
Yes, hello. They're going to do... this, and this is from notebookingpages.com. Well, it was notebookingpages.com. They have now changed to productivehomeschooling.com, and that's from Deborah Reed, and they are amazing. So we've got these kind of sheets that you can just print out. This is all our geography stuff. We're doing a unit study on Australia, and so it's got geography on the map. And then we also have, I've printed off the next lot, we're learning all the continents. So this has everything about the continent. Shayla's studying.